Hey traders, Akil here from the Triple Threat Trading Live Ratio Room. Wanted to do something a little bit different this week before we get our video started and kind of let you meet the trader. Now I know a lot of you know my background. You've either been with me in the live room, have friended me on Facebook, or a member of our Facebook group page. But a lot of you haven't actually seen a face that goes with the name or a face that goes with the voice. So wanted to give you a chance to see the ugly mug. I know if ratings drop after this week's video, I know it's why. I've probably scared some of you off. If not, then this may be something I continue to do. Now, this week's video is going to be a little short. Didn't have a lot of time to record. Since we had a lot of Ratio Master Series members in the room this week, I spent a lot of overtime answering additional questions. So didn't have a lot of time to record the trades that we took. With that being said, it just overall wasn't a very busy week either. It was a profitable week. I think I was up about 70 pips for the week, but no spectacular trades, no once-in-a-lifetime patterns, no super secret techniques, just a pure, basic, boring, profitable trading. So, give you some examples of that in this week's video. Make sure you read the write-up I did if you haven't already. I am going to talk about a pretty cool win streak we had in the live room during that write-up that has actually just came to an end. But other than that, I will see you next week. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you're able to get something from it. Take care, traders. Okay, traders, just finished up Wednesday's live room session, and I'm going to recap one of the trades we took. We actually had a pretty good day. We were 2 for 2 with a winner on both euro yen and euro dollar, and nothing really special today, just structure based trades. Now we'll take a look at euro dollar, what I was looking at, and let's see, we're up about 25 pips right now, shooting for target 2, but let's take those down, clear off the chart, and I'll show you what we looked at. Now start the day off by looking for a trend continuation type setup, and we had basically the same thing on euro dollar. And we saw this. Looking at structure, we saw the market had put in this previous structure level where tested it over here, tested it once again, and finally made a move above it. Now we also had an ABCD completion there as well, and I talked to our trend continuation or trend trading followers, counter trend followers, there we go, long day, that you can also enter short up here if you had a double top. That's a story for another time. But what I was looking for was a retest of our structure zone. So a retest of this zone down here. So firstly, brought in the Fibonacci extension or retracement from our big move. Swing low all the way to our swing high. Said, hey, we have a 3D2 right at that structure level, which is a good sign. Brought in another Fibonacci retracement from our latest move up. Bang, lined up with a 618 retracement. And even if we take a middle move in here, we'll probably get a minor Fibonacci retracement as well. We'll get a 50% a little lower than that. So we have two Fibonacci retracements lining up in the same area. If we zoom in some more or even go down to the range bar charts, we can see that we also have a potential ABCD completion coming into this level as well, bringing our Fibonacci extension tool from A down to B and back up, 127 extension, and just to make us seem a little fancy, we'll take a Fibonacci inversion, which again is a backwards extension from our inside leg, so our C leg back to our B leg, bring that back up, and we have a 1618. So needless to say, we have a big cluster of Fibonacci retracements and extensions lining up right at a structure zone. So what do? Bought it up. Took target ones off at a retest of this structure. Normally I would have chased it a little higher or took it a little higher for profits, but if we bring a line in at this structure zone, we'll see we come in to another area structure, and of course I want to be as safe as possible, put the money in my pocket as soon as possible, and then move stops to break even. And that's where we're at right now. We have extended targets a little higher I'm looking for a test up here, and we have a potential cipher pattern forming a little bit higher as well. But we already got our money off the table, at least for half our position, and the rest is all free money.
Thank you.